I have 5 minutes. Let me tell you what you need to know. We are pleased to announce the monumental feat to the world that the Honorable Silas Muhammad wrote the definition of our identity that represents 250 million Afro-descendants that is now accepted by the United Nations, the collective body of governments in the world. The term Afro-descendants refers to people who were forcibly dispossessed of their homeland, Africa. Number two, were transported to America in slavery diaspora for the purpose of enslavement. Number three, were subjected to slavery, were subjected to forced mixed breeding and rape. Number five, have experienced through force the loss of mother tongue, culture, and religion, and have experienced racial discrimination due to the loss from their original identity. Every time you hear the term Afro-descendant, know that the Honorable Silas Muhammad wrote the definition for the term Afro-descendant. Today, we have a name. We have an identity. It's called Afro-descendants. The Lost Foundation of Islam gave birth to the Afro-descendant nation, political entity. I'm sure that some of you probably have never heard of that before. But the Afro-descendant nation is that body that can help make reparation a reality for all of our people. In order to sue for reparations, you need a name. This we have achieved. The name Afro-descendants is recognized in the United Nations. This recognition includes 250 million Afro-descendants. That leader, that representative, the United States of America in 2002, and La Ceiba, Honduras, was the most honorable Silas Muhammad. Now that we have a name recognized in the United Nations, we have standing to sue the United States government, but we need your unity. How many of you would like to stand and help us sue this United States government for all of her wrong done to our people? Brothers and sisters, I have enjoyed being with you, and I hope that I have not offended you in my spirit of unity. I love black people. Not only love black people, I have an undying love for black people. There is the difference. And I greet you as I found you in peace. Assalamu alaikum.
I started off thinking I was teaching him, he was teaching me. our keynote speaker. I'd like for you to get on your feet and give him a round of applause. His brother was struggling. He went into the penal system at a young age. And some people don't understand, but I do. I look past his faults and look into his heart. And that's what I do with most of my people. I had most people tell me I shouldn't have this person. This person shouldn't. This person didn't. Y'all know this little star called something out of love. What do they hate this? Stand on your feet for the keynote speaker, Brother Everett S.
By the moon,
one night by the stars, was awesome by the time. So the time becomes the evidence to the point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make. Was awesome. And all the same lot be Christian. Author, time. Salatul Asr is the last prayer of the day. Muslims say, oh, it's last Isha. Asr is the last prayer of the day. The next prayer is Maghrib, sunset prayer. And then Isha. But the last prayer of the day is Asr. Asr deals with time, but not just time. It is fleeting time. Time that is leaving. Time that you can't get back. Wal Asr, by the time. In all the same lofty cushion. Surely man is lost. How do we know that man is lost? By the time. So the time becomes evidence. And if you don't know the time and what must be done, you'll be doing something else at the wrong time. Well, often, in all the same lofty cushion, I always like to infuse Arabic in my talk to people. And I'm a student of Nahu Basaf, Arabic grammar and morphology. And I can't speak to it. I can read like 7 languages. It's full for beliefs. It's the same as mu'minun, believers. Or mu'min. Mu'min is a believer. Mu'minun is the plurality of believers. Mu'minna is a feminine believer, a female believer. Illa latina aminu wa aminu. Aminu. Emil. Emil means a worker, a doer. One who does the work. Aminu. Workers. Surely by the time man is lost, except. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an exception to those who are lost. The exception are the ones who believe. But belief counts for nothing except it is carried into practice. And when the Rashi started, B, always ask Allah to make my actions match my knowledge. Sometimes, you know, one eyed man can't get a land of the blind. And sometimes I'm around a lot of blind people. And I want my actions to always measure up. But they don't. Because I'm blessed. If that makes any sense. Sometimes being blessed with hikmah or ism, knowledge and wisdom, that's a blessing, but sometimes it's a curse. If your actions don't match up to the information, and sometimes you deal with blind people, they put some expectations on you. Everybody can know what I'm talking about. They put some expectations on you that won't allow you to fall, won't allow you to stumble, won't allow you to clip. The Quran says, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the shaitan made a slip. That don't mean that the devil threw a banana peel in there. That don't mean he baby oil in the tub. Illa athina aminu wa aminu saliha. You have to be doers of righteous deeds. Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a knowledgeable believer is harder on the devil than 1,000 ignorant worshippers. The ink of a scholar is more important in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the blood of your mouth. The man who is in search of knowledge is on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until he returns. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said that when we are students, we should never come back. In our quest for knowledge, we should never return. We should never feel that we've arrived, that we got it. Because the moment you think you got it, that's when you lost it. Encourage one another with truth. I was talking to someone last night. We don't know how to be friends with one another. We don't know how to tell you the truth and still be cool. If I tell you the truth, when you're friends with one. I can't exhort you in truth, and you can't exhort me in truth because you're going to make me mad. You're going to hurt my feelings. You know I got a little self-esteem. Right? And we know we're dysfunctional, and we normalize dysfunctionalities in our community. I'm just doing it. I've been like this all my life, Jack. Right? Except those who believe and do good, and exhort one another to truth, and exhort one another to sorrow, patience. not patient with one another. But we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be patient with us. You know God ain't through with us yet. That's what we say, right? What was the original intentions of Allah when he created the human being?
Good question.
Because we're talking about uniting the ummah and closing a gap. What is a gap and how are gaps formed? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human being, in the Quran, in Surah 2, Ayah 30, there was a conversation. And when the Lord said to the angels, surely I will make on the earth, in Arabic, Khalifa. Khalifa comes from Arabic, based on the tribal rule system. Three letters, I try. Tribal root, ka, la, fa, means he succeeded, one who has perished or died. The caliph. Abu Bakr was the caliph of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uthman, Uman, Ali, the caliphate, the plurality of caliph, the successor. In the Quran, Adam is called the first caliph. How is Adam a khalifa, a successor to one who perishes or dies if he's the first person? Because Islam does not shut down your ability to think. Being a critical thinker and an analytical thinker doesn't nullify your Islam. I know religious folk, you don't want to question the word. You got to question the word so you can answer some questions. You know, when you're a Muslim, you're a missionary. When you're a Muslim, you automatically an activist. When you're a Muslim, you help people. Or you need some instructions. If you need some instruction, you're not a Muslim. You're a slave, like Dr. Ali said. Your instructions come from your heart. Your instructions come from your spirit. If a man come and just smack your wife, you need a manual. In the Quran, Allah said, I made you the different tribes and nations that you may know one another. Different tribes. But we are one. We are one. And I wanted to use the Quran to emphasize our unity. Because it is what binds us together. I've never met a Muslim that said that. So if that is what binds us, then that's what we should emphasize. The standard of Allah. Because you know, we want to use our standard. Everybody, I like that, y'all. Y'all might not like it, bro. By the time, surely man is lost, except those who believe and do good and exhort one another to truth. Can we just be honest with one another?
Yes, sir.
You know how you build brotherhood? When I was in prison, under 18 years in prison, and my life was embarrassing. There was a time when you talk about the background, and it was embarrassing. But now, so much hell in our community, that's like credibility. I was in the jump for 18 years, and it's like a badge of honor. I'm walking in it. Real black man. And we have an issue. Coming from prison, I had a mission. It was the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, who is my teacher, who inspired me to become self-inspired. Well, you can't say you're self-inspired. You know, as acting and dealing with black people, I worked on Ward 8, Southeast DC, and the poorest ward in District of Columbia. And when you deal with young people, like I deal with young people, we are dysfunctional. And we can't say it. We can't be honest with one another. We can't tell the truth that we're dysfunctional. All of us are dysfunctional.
Yes, sir.
I said everybody in this room.
Come on, brother.
I can't say that and still be cool. I'm dysfunctional too. I'm not trying to screw myself. We all are striving, but we have to acknowledge that.
Right.
We can't be brothers if we can't be honest with one another. We can't tell the truth and exhort one another to the truth and then exhort one another to patience. It's a process. Resurrection, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said, resurrection is a process that begins with the self-accusing spirit and does not end until we become one in complete harmony with Allah, God, and His creation. Who is in harmony, complete harmony with Allah, God, and His creation? Raise your hand. So it's a process. And if it's a process, that implies that all of us are on a journey. All of us are pilgrims. To make a pilgrimage in which Hajj or Mecca or the Kaaba is a sign of.
Come on.
Because you know, that's a ritual. But the ritual serves a purpose.
Yes, sir.
And if you can go into the ritual and extract the spiritual meaning and principle and inculcate the principle, the ritual becomes insignificant.
Right.
The lesson.
The lesson.
By the time, surely man is lost. If you look at our community, I have a homosexual niece. I'm going to talk about my niece. I hope she won't be mad if she watches this. She was talking about me, but you can say she's a gay bride. So, let me talk about her. We was talking last night, me and my niece, and I was telling her, you know, we go back and forward, and I used the word females in the text, and I didn't know that you can't say female to a lesbian. That's like misogynistic. I didn't know that till last night. Surely, by the time man is lost, my niece told me you're so misogynistic. Because I said female. I said, when I said female, female to me is a synonym for sister. That's all I meant. Pardon me for not saying sister. We lost. We are in need of repair. They have a homosexual masjid in Virginia. In the name of the Al-Fatiha, the
old one.
We're lost as a people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put it on the Muslim.
Come on.
It is the Muslim. The Quran says the blind and seeing are not alike. I didn't say it. Allah said it. The blind and the seeing are not alike. The Quran says you are the best nation raised up among men.
Yes.
You enjoy what is good and forbid that which is evil. That So if you still got your good, you're a Muslim. Because Muslims submit their will to do who will. So the Muslim submits his will. Muslims don't have a will. Submit our will to do the will of Allah. So if you and I submit our will to do the will of Allah, then Allah will begin to express itself through us. Stop the wrong thing. If you can't submit your will and become, the Quran teaches, we become what we submit to. That we become what we submit to. If you submit to a lie, what are you?
A liar.
So if you submit to the truth, what are you?
Truth.
But it can't be the truth because the truth is at the heart. This is an attribute of Allah. So I know I'm a liar. Surely man is lost except those who believe. Believe in what? All of us don't even believe in the same thing. And if we need to talk about our beliefs, then the division gets it. If we need to talk about our beliefs, we bound to hear more, I don't believe that, than I believe that. Right? If we get the nuances of our belief, because we surface dwellers, right? As a people, we don't emphasize principles. We don't have them. We're not sophisticated or mature enough to emphasize principles. We are so messed up and lost. All we do, we are professional fault finders. Professional fault finders with one another. I heard somebody up there, I forgot, he said, you can do all good. He said, you do one thing bad, that's all the people remember. Dr. Lane, I was in the penitentiary watching you on a DVD. And I'm on the panel with him today. Is God real? Knowledge is power. You've ever heard that knowledge is power. So I've been blessed with some information. make your action match the word. One of y'all said it today. Come on, one more give it to me real quick. I ain't got 2 more minutes.
Be the message that you bring?
Bring the message that you bring. Be the message that you bring. And so we have to be the message that we bring. We have to organize our community. As a Muslim, you are already ordained by Allah to be a leader.
That's right.
You can't be a Muslim and not be a leader.
Go ahead,
bro. By virtue of saying you're a Muslim, it automatically makes you a leader.
That's right.
I had a young woman yesterday. He was focused on weed. I said, you can't smoke weed. He said, why are they smoking? You're a Muslim. The blind is saying, I'm not worried. You can't do it either. Ain't wrong enough to do that.
Yes, sir.
So, in conclusion, thank you. I hope I've said something that can inspire. I hope I've tried to say something to bring us all together. I don't know everyone, but generally, I love all of y'all. And may Allah continue you and keep you, bless you, and keep us safe and keep us together. I see Minister Khadid. Let's be brother Minister Khadid.
I'd like to present the first award, the Future Safe Award, to Brother Anthony B. Muhammad and his wife. Please sit down.
The Safe Award. That's easy.
Thank you.
This is the Uplifting of Fallen Humanity Award.
To one of my greatest inspirations that I like everybody else in this panel. I looked at a great businessman, a man who was what you call a self-made millionaire. Nothing. Working out of the bottom of his basement, making the sacrifice, losing his family, losing his wife, just for the sake of law, but he gained everything. The law gave him everything that he had. He has a beautiful wife who stands beside him and understands him. This brother has been through a lot, and he is the pioneer of this movement. I thank Allah for him in this example, and I'm going to let his daughter present the award to him. Brother is one of the great minds of our time. Well, he's in the ministry. He's in the community. Annapolis, Noble. This brother right here, this had a beautiful, beautiful conference. He had all the children there. And your boy, Brother Lori Muhammad there, and they had a great time. My family went out there, and they loved it, and recorded. And I couldn't be there, but I was there in spirit, because my family was there. I'd like to bring to you Brother Student Troy Muhammad. Disappeared. This brother was in the Nation of Islam, and still is. His brother was a person that I could always call on to help me. We went through our trials and tribulations. But I looked past his fall into his heart. People said, give up. We had our business ties and I had a wife on here. Leave him alone. Come on. But I understand that I had to rise above my emotions to think of God. Regardless of that, because I learned to love instead of hate. I reward his brother home for his legacy. Brother Charlie Muhammad. Next award goes to one of the great assistants of Dr. Ali Abdul Muhammad. This brother is another brother that stayed strong with his host during the time, the rough times that we had in the mosque. His brother had one of the most successful mosques, the PD mosque, when I was incarcerated. I used to say I couldn't wait to get home to help him because I heard about the great work that he was doing and he was moving. We didn't forget about you, brother. I did. Our next award will go to Minister Sean Muhammad. Thank you. family teaches to be a good example, regardless of what goes on. I know what you mean. Love you, brother. We're going to close up. Even as sometimes it's going to close us out, and we're going to all go to 7:15. Even sometimes I'm going to end his prayer, so everyone stands up.
YouTube channel that Facebook does not get. All right, thank you. Peace.